Many years before the US Federal Bureau of Investigation was created, the Pinkerton National Detective Agency took on law enforcement for the growing nation. Its founder was an accidental detective. In 1842, Scottish-born Allan Pinkerton immigrated to the Chicago area and established a cooperage, or barrel-making business. His detective career was launched just 5 years later when he chanced upon a band of counterfeiters while collecting lumber from an island in the Fox River. He carried out informal surveillance on the gang and was lauded as a local hero when he helped police make arrests. The affair suddenly gave him a public profile, and he received requests from all over town to investigate matters requiring detective skills. Eventually, Pinkerton became a small town sheriff, then graduated to work as Chicago's first police detective with responsibilities for the US Post Office. In about 1850, he opened his private investigation firm to be known as the Pinkerton National Detective Agency. The Pinkerton Agency first earned its credentials in the late 1850s by hunting down outlaws and providing private security for railroads. As the company's profile increased, its powerful logo, a large staring eye, underscored by the slogan, "We never sleep," created the term Private Eye as a nickname for detectives. Uniquely, Pinkerton's hired minorities from its outset and the country's first female detectives. In 1856, despite Pinkerton's initial reluctance, a 23-year-old widow, Kate Warne, convinced him that she could undercover secrets in many areas that a male detective would find it impossible to access. Accordingly, Warne proved to be adept at undercover work, once exposing a thief by befriending his wife and persuading her to disclose the location of his stash. In another case, she extracted crucial information from a suspect through impersonating a fortune teller. The Pinkertons also claimed to have prevented an assassination attempt on Abraham Lincoln. Shortly before the president-elect's first inauguration in March 1861, Allan Pinkerton was in Baltimore investigating rumors for a railroad company that there was a threat of sabotage of the rail lines to Washington, D.C. While sniffing out undercover intelligence, he discovered that a secret cabal also plotted to assassinate Lincoln while in his whistle-stop tour when he changed trains in Baltimore on his journey to the capital. Pinkerton immediately informed Lincoln of the alleged conspiracy and devised a plan for him to secretly board an overnight train and travel through Baltimore several hours before his published schedule. Pinkerton operatives also cut telegraph lines to prevent the conspirators from communicating with each other, while Warne had Lincoln pose as an invalid brother to conceal his identity. Lincoln arrived safely in Washington the next day, but was mocked as a coward by the press. As none of the would-be assassins was ever identified, some historians have suggested that the threat may have been magnified or even invented by Pinkerton. Nevertheless, Lincoln was to later hire Pinkerton agents for his personal security during the Civil War. Allan Pinkerton was a committed abolitionist and Union supporter, and during the Civil War, he conducted a secret intelligence service for the Army of the Potomac. He established spy rings behind enemy lines, gained access to Southern sympathizer groups in the North, and even had agents interview escaped slaves to gather information about the Confederacy. While his operation garnered reams of intelligence, not all of it proved accurate. A famous mistake came during the 1862 Peninsula Campaign when Pinkerton communicated that the Confederate forces around Richmond were more than double their actual numbers. Major General McClellan believed the unsound intel, and despite massively outnumbering the rebels, he held back his advance while making repeated calls for reinforcements. The Pinkertons also war with Jesse James and his gang. During the epoch of frontier expansion, mail delivery companies and railways often hired the Pinkertons as Wild West bounty hunters. The agency effectively infiltrated the Reno gang, who committed the nation's first train robbery, and later pursued Butch Cassidy and his Wild Bunch. While the Pinkertons were usually successful in apprehending suspects, in the 1870s they spent months engaged in fruitless pursuit of the bank robbers Jess and Frank James. One of their agents was blown away while attempting to infiltrate the brothers' Missouri-based gang, and two more were slain in a shootout. In 1875, the Pinkertons finally launched a raid on the James brothers' mother's home in Clay County, Missouri. Frank and Jess had been tipped off and fled. But during a standoff with their mother, Zerelda Samuel, a Pinkerton detective threw an incendiary device through a window, blowing off part of her arm and slaying the James brothers' 8-year-old half-brother. The bungle raid turned public opinion against the Pinkertons, and Allan Pinkerton regretfully ended his war against the James gang. The Pinkertons also took on a more sinister role as the mercenary enforcers of big business. Industrialists employed them to spy on unions, recruit goon squads, and keep strikers and suspected unionists out of factories. Performing as guards and strikebreakers, the detectives fought with workers on many occasions. In 1892, during a strike by the Amalgamated Association of Iron and Steel Workers, the Carnegie Steel Company hired 300 Pinkerton detectives as security guards at its mill in Homestead, Pennsylvania. Travelling to the plant on river barges, the agents took on thousands of striking workers in a day-long battle, fought with guns, bricks, and even dynamite. The outnumbered Pinkertons eventually surrendered, leaving 16 fatal casualties and 23 injured. The fallout from the skirmish decimated the steel union, but also earned the Pinkertons a descriptor, "hired thugs," causing several states to legislate bans on the use of private guards in labour disputes. This was later followed by the Federal Anti-Pinkerton Act in 1893. In 1896, Denver Pinkerton detective John Conklin Fraser was assigned to a dark case which highlighted the problems of the private operatives. He was hired to investigate the disappearance of Albert and Henry Fountain. Colonel Albert Jennings Fountain was a high-profile New Mexico Territory lawyer who had been staying in the town of Lincoln to serve in the prosecution of cattle thieves. He and his 8-year-old son Henry departed Lincoln for home, but on their third day of travel, both disappeared near the White Sands dune field. Amidst the public outrage was the complication that the crime occurred within the jurisdiction of a Sheriff Guadalupe Escarate, whose right to the office was being legally contested due to allegations of election fraud, and was also said to be in the pocket of Fountain's powerful political rival. His deputies were all suspects in the Fountain's disappearance. Because of the conflict of interest, the governor had brought in the outside help of Fraser and a retired sheriff called Pat Garrett, who was known for having secured the demise of Billy the Kid in 1881. Undertaking the investigation, Fraser encountered a tense atmosphere, with locals too scared to talk. Some people did implicate Escarate's deputies, though there was no direct evidence against them. The testimony indicated a sinister shattering of father and son by five different perpetrators along their journey. Fraser later reported that he found it impossible to do a proper investigation, with Garrett withholding information and lying to him. The case progressed slowly until 3 years later, two of the men were brought to trial regarding only Henry Fountain's probable slaying. However, they were found not guilty and never tried over Albert Fountain's disappearance. As the remains of father and son were never found, the case ran cold and remained unsolved. One of the many innovations the Pinkertons brought to law enforcement was the establishment of one of the world's first criminal databases. The so-called Rogues Gallery was a catalogue of mugshots and case histories that the agency drew on to research and keep track of wanted offenders. As well as annotating suspects, distinguishing features and scars, agents also collated newspaper cuttings and produced a rap sheet listing their prior arrests, known associates and areas of expertise. A more sophisticated criminal library would not be compiled until the early 20th century, with the birth of the FBI. After Allan Pinkerton's passing in 1884, control of his agency came under two sons, Robert and William. The company continued to expand under their management and by the 1890s employed a team of 2,000 detectives and 30,000 reserves, more personnel than in the then permanent Army of the United States. Concerned that the agency could be bought off as a private mercenary force, the state of Ohio later outlawed the Pinkertons completely. Pinkerton was the largest private law enforcement agency in the world at the height of its power, helping to usher in the modern era of crime fighting. By the early 20th century, Pinkerton's role had largely been commandeered by local police forces and agencies, like the FBI, which was formed in 1908. The company continued as a private security firm and guard service, and still operates today worldwide.